Hey people, what's up? So, first successful rehouse. This is Phaedra. And finally, I'm able to see her. She is gorgeous, and as you can see, this is a medium arboreal tank. She is pretty big after her mold in my care. Let me see if I can actually put her somewhere else so the light is doing her more justice. Give me a second. All right, I'd like to emphasize, this is not her place. I just tried putting her here so actually you can see her a little bit better. There we go. She is gorgeous. And transfer was totally easy too. She didn't throw a thread gesture, she didn't run, she didn't bite, nothing. It was totally easy. She went like just easily over her old cage, over there, over the counter of it, and went straight in. So hopefully she'll like this. And yeah, on to the next one. All right, next rehousing video, or rather housing video. This is the Homoeomma, or whatever it's called. I don't know how to pronounce it really in English. Homoeomma spec blue it is. It's often mistaken for E. pulcherrimatlassi, Euatleth pulcherrimatlassi, Pidgeonangui blue beauty, or blue femur is the common name, I guess. As much as I know from spidershop.co.uk. This little guy here, I don't know how quick he is. But, yeah, I'll rehouse them. First of all, I found these really nice, finally, some, you know, with already these meshes. So, yep, that's good, I guess. And let's see how this goes. I guess this guy is at least as skittish as my other one, the Atlas. So I guess I just put his little box in the container over there, and then open the freaking lid, because like I said, I have a hurt hand and I'm really not in the mood to chase around a spider currently. I'm really happy that everything went fine with my Pierminia, because she was first part, actually she was like, I don't know, different. Oops. And he wants to go up and I want him to go down. Let's go. Come on, down there. Not up, down. Wow. Ass in the air. Come on. Come on, little guy. Down there. And yeah, he's skittish. Done. Alright, this is a little bit more of a rare one. This is an Avicularia azuraklaasi. It has been obviously sexed under the binocular, being a female, but yeah, anyways, I guess we'll see, and let's see how this little guy is actually. Come on. Oh, jeez. Come out there. Yeah, she's scared. As usual, these. Come on. That's your new home. There we go. That's actually a really nice transfer, because she is totally nice. And yeah, let's go to the next one. Alrighty, the next one I'm going to do is the Heterothele villosella, the H. villosella, the African old world species. This is a dwarf species, as you can see, she's not really big. And, she has huge spinnerets. She looks a lot like a diplurid, actually, but in fact is a tarantula. She already has webbed up the whole little container here. You can't see that really, but... they are heavy webbers, and yeah, John, if you're watching this, I suggested getting one for you. If you remember when you asked what you should get next, I don't know, this one is actually nearly full grown, so as you can see, they are really small, but I don't know, I think if I remember correctly, you actually like the dwarf species quite some. These are said to be lightning fast. Not so much like a Pierminia, but close to. And so far, apparently no one ever got bitten by one of these. I mean, let's not talk about size of tarantulas and venom potency, because I don't think it's dependent on the size, actually. Just on the tarantula itself. Either way, I need to prepare her enclosure now. And, yeah, then I'll be back with rehousing her. Alright, since this is my first old world species, and I only know that they are freaking fast, so far I've not read any bite reports of them, but I still want to avoid getting bitten. I think that's pretty usual. Anyways, I'm hoping that this works out well, because I'm just gonna remove the lid now. Or not, because it's stuck. And, yeah. I'll just give her a slight tap, and hopefully she doesn't run. And you can't see that, really. Let me see if I can actually make her go out of her little thing there. I just hope she will, but... And there you go, and you saw that. She is actually going after the straw, which means this little guy is a little bit more aggressive than thought first. The breeder actually told me that they usually are not aggressive at all, more totally scared. But since she already showed some aggression there, I'm going to leave her be and let her crawl out on her own, which she is currently doing. I don't know if you can see her. Let me zoom in a little bit. There she is. So, yep. She's a little bit silly there, though. Doesn't want to leave her container. Okay, girl. I want you, and I need you to go out there, though. Let's see. They seem to be pretty feisty, actually, for their size. Let's see. She walks out that way. Well, I'll get back once I have her up. Well, actually, that was easier than I thought. As you can see, she webbed up this whole enclosure already, this little transport thing. Well, she's in there, and I know that this container is way too big for her usually, but like I said, currently, I think it's a good idea to put her in there, because I want to see her, and she is currently down there somewhere. Oh, there she is. Ow. She's down there. I don't know if you can see her. Don't think so. She's sitting on the cork bark. yeah, I just hope that she feels good in there. And that's about it. Well, it's not a real big deal getting her in there. Okay, now for the last two avics. Be right back. Alrighty, let's go. Here's another versicolor baby. And, yep. As known, they are quick, they are fast, and they like to jump. And, actually, sometimes, like, as you see Rob C's channel, they sometimes even try to bite you, but at this size, this is seriously nothing to be scared of anyways. Where is she? There she is. Out, baby. Aw, so blue. So blue. Yep. Out there. Whoops. That was not my intention, but I'm thinking she's already in there now. Yeah, I guess so. Yep, she's in. She's down there. I can see her. I don't know if you can see her. She is there. There she wags. You see that? Alright. Okay, enough for the diversity. Alright. Last one, people. This will be the diversipus avicularia. I wanted one of those for a long time. And, there's a collar breeder where I got all my spiders from so far. Well, except a few others. Was so nice to send me one as a freebie. Yup, diversipus. Yay! at this point, again, thanks a lot, Helmut. Really happy about this, so let's see. Where's the little guy? Oh! These have hatched in December, but they are really tiny. Tiny, 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 tiny. This will be a castle for him. And this is already the smallest size that I got. Come out there, little guy. Come out. Yeah, come out. Down there, down there. There you go.